Hey guys, this is my first design team project for the cross promotion that Craft Supplies One is doing with Gina's Designs. We are all doing projects, including products from Gina's store and Julie's store, Craft Supplies One. So I got one of these perpetual calendars in my kit for this month, and I made it for myself. So I used Graphic 45 Sweet Sentiments. I really like that paper. I think it's really pretty and vintage, and kind of shabby chic at the same time because it has color to it. So let's start with basically with these, you get everything included. And what I did was I just painted them up and then I glued the numbers down. I wanted to keep the natural wood look. And you get all the numbers, and then for the days, same thing. I painted it a pink to match. And then February, same thing up here. Oh, and inside, what I did basically with this, it's a dark wood. I painted it all cream. And then I did some of the sand. I put sand with paint. And I did it all on the inside. So I really like how that came out. And then I covered the rest of it that I didn't paint. You can see the sand over here too. I covered it in the paper and on the back. And I'll start up here. Up top, I used seam binding and I made a bow. And then over here, this is one of the really pretty butterflies that Julie carries, and they're flat. And they're just, simple. So what I did was I tried some stickles and it really came out good. I put some blue and then pink over here, kind of to make it look more like a piece of jewelry, like with some, like bling to it. And then in the center, it's flat and it has an oval. So I just cut out one of the angels or cherubs from the paper collection, and then I put stickles over them. I don't know if it's girl or boy. And then bent it, manipulated it to get the shape. So I really like how that came out. And they're so versatile, those butterflies. So then over here, I used another metal piece from Craft Supplies One, and I just painted it up with some tan and white, and then rubbed it off so you could see the bronze, because I like that. And then these fern fronds are from Gina's store, and I just kind of painted them up, just went over it. I put a doily over here. This trim is from Julie's store. I think it looks like flowers, so it's like in the garden. I think it looks really cute there. And then here's some more of the trim all the way up. And then on this side, I put a doily behind it and another beautiful metal piece from Julie's store. Two of them. There's one in the center, and these pearls you can pick up there too. And I just painted it. And then another fern frond over here. And then, oh, and I have this in my stash, just a cabochon. Over here, I use the banners that I received also. Another cabochon over here. I took some seam binding and glued some of the crocheted trim from Julie's store. I just cut off the end of it. And these are, two layers. You get both layers in the, I think I have the bag right here. They're called Banner Builder Pennant Minis. And I just cut out some of the, images from the paper. So I think that it goes really good on the side, how it's, kind of like draped down. And then I left some over here. And then on the bottom, I don't want everything to come out. I just put some felt so it wouldn't be so rough on my desk. So there's my little project for Gina's Designs and Craft Supplies One. And make sure and check out Gina's blog. We're going to have all our pictures up on there. And her other designers are going to be cross promoting for us for Craft Supplies One. And make sure and check out Julie's store. There's a sale going on right now for March. And let me know what you guys think. Okay? Take care. Bye.